The greatest obstacle to living is expectancy, which hangs upon tomorrow and loses today. The whole future lies in uncertainty. Live immediately. Seneca. Recently, I've been thinking a lot about time. Time is what stops everything happening all at once. Time is the most frequently used noun in the English language, and nothing seems more basic or real than time. Yet many philosophers like Zeno of Elea find it deeply puzzling. Some like MacTaggart even claim time is unreal. Of course, philosophers often find reasons to doubt the existence of things we take for granted. But with time, it's not just philosophers, it's physicists too, like Stephen Hawking or Carlo Rovelli, just to name a few. Whether time exists or not, time perception, our sense of time, does. We all know what it feels like as time passes. Our present becomes a past as soon as it's happened. Today soon turns into yesterday. And as we reach adulthood and beyond, we become increasingly aware of our years flashing by. For example, if someone tells us they're arriving in 5 minutes, we have a rough idea of when to start to look out for them. We have a sense of the weeks and months passing by. As a result, most of us would say that how time functions is fairly obvious. Time has an arrow, passing at a consistent and measurable rate in a specific direction, from past to future, constantly running out. But is it really? We're often too busy to spend time with the ones we care about. The very parent at the park playing on his phone while his children run around playing and laughing is the same one who, when you fast forward the era of time, wants those precious moments back. Likewise, the busy 30-something who can't make time to see their parents wishes to have them back after they're gone. They wish for more time with them. There's just too much going on and we become distracted. We're always distracted. So much so that the interaction with fellow humans is becoming kind of weird. Our cell phone is now more interesting than most people around us. We think that time is ours to waste. We even say we have 2 hours to kill or speak of dead time between appointments. The irony. Because time is the one that's killing us. Each minute that passes is not just dead to us, it brings us closer to being dead. The average human only spends roughly 79 years or 29,000 days on Earth. Which may sound like a lot for some, but can feel too little for others. So the question is, are you spending your days the way you want to spend your life? We all know time is a finite resource. While the amount of time we get is uncertain, we know it's limited. We can't make any more of it when it runs out. So an interesting question about this phenomenon I ask myself is this. What is it that makes it so easy for us to waste time? Surely, our phones and social media are just a part of the time scarcity problem. There's our job, the kids, the unfulfilled dreams. It seems like there's no time to do anything, so we end up doing nothing. Are you starting to glimpse the problem here? A problem which Lucius Aeneas Seneca, better known as Seneca or Seneca the Younger, has already recognized 2,000 years ago. It is not that we have a short time to live, but that we waste a lot of it. He was a Roman Stoic philosopher and statesman who became one of the most influential figures of the Roman imperial period. In his moral essay on the shortness of life, written in 49 AD, addressed to his father-in-law Paulinus, Seneca offers us an urgent reminder on the non-renewability of our most important resource, our time, and reveals a puzzling paradox in human life. We know that our time is limited, yet we live like it's not. In a world of constant busyness, Seneca urges us to get off the hamster wheel of life and live each day like it's our last. Time is only short if you waste it. He argues that it's our wastefulness of time that makes life feel short. It's not that we have a short space of time, but that we waste much of it. Life is long enough and it has been given in sufficient generous measure to allow the accomplishment of the very greatest things if the whole of it is well invested. But when it is squandered in luxury and carelessness, when it is devoted to no good end, forced at last by the ultimate necessity, we perceive that it has passed away before we were aware that it was passing. So, it is the life we receive is not short, but we make it so, nor do we have any lack of it, but are wasteful of it. This shows that Seneca's thoughts run contrary to popular thinking that time or life is short. You have enough time to accomplish your goals and live an extraordinary life, as long as you treat time as your most precious resource. Value your time more than your possessions. If we see someone throwing away money, we call that person crazy. Money has value. Wasting it seems foolish. And yet we see others and ourselves throw away something far more valuable every day. Time. Unlike money, which can be squandered and regained, we can never get back time. People are frugal in guarding their personal property. But as soon as it comes to squandering time, they are most wasteful of the one thing in which it is right to be stingy. What's ironic about this quote is that Seneca was one of the wealthiest men in Rome during his lifetime and one of the closest advisors of Emperor Nero. But what's not ironic is that despite his wealth, Seneca seemed to be mostly indifferent to it. He consciously chose to periodically deprive himself of the luxuries he had available so that his peace of mind and happiness would never come to depend on possessing them. By stripping away all the externals as often as he could, he made sure that he most valued the only thing he could truly lose and which would never return, his time. Because Seneca knew that if he spent his time on the things that truly mattered, like self-reflection, bonding with friends and loved ones, or meaningful work, then the rest of his life would fall into place. There's laziness, and then there's procrastination. Lazy people never do what they're supposed to do for a multitude of reasons. It's too hard, it takes too long, they don't feel like it, whatever. But those prone to procrastination merely put things off. They tell themselves, "Oh, I'm definitely going to do it, but not right this second." Or, "I've got time later in the week." This is most of us. We care about getting the important stuff done. Often we care so much it eats at us in the form of anxiety. Putting things off is the biggest waste of life. It snatches away each day as it comes and denies us the present by promising the future. The greatest obstacle to living is expectancy, which hangs upon tomorrow and loses today. You are arranging what lies in fortune's control and abandoning what lies in yours. What are you looking at? To what goal are you straining? The whole future lies in uncertainty. Live immediately. According to Seneca, the real reason why we waste so much of our time isn't poor time management. It's that we often forget that we are going to die. You live as if you were destined to live forever. No thought of your frailty ever enters your head. Of how much time has already gone by, you take no heed. You squander time as if you drew from a full and abundant supply. Though all the while that day which you bestow on some person or thing is perhaps your last. Our perception of death affects how we live our lives. This is our big mistake, to think we look forward to death. Most of death is already gone. Whatever time has passed is owned by death. The further away we perceive our death to be, the more likely we'll take today for granted and waste valuable time. How you spend your days is, of course, how you spend your life. Seneca argues that busyness is an illusion of productivity that actually steals our valuable time. No activity can be successfully pursued by an individual who is preoccupied. Since the mind, when distracted, absorbs nothing deeply, but rejects everything, which is, so to speak, crammed into it. Living is the least important activity of the preoccupied man. Yet there is nothing which is harder to learn. We often blame external triggers, people, social media, emails, for our inability to avoid distractions and stay focused. But in reality, it's our internal state of emotions that influences our productivity. Busyness is a symptom of a negative internal state of emotions. It's the avoidance of much-needed solitude and an escape from reality. That's why I challenge you to spend 1 hour per week alone in a room with nothing but your thoughts. No music, no books, no meditation guides, no technology. After all, being busy is a decision, and refusing to accept that is our greatest source of unhappiness. Because the presence is infinitely more rewarding than productivity. A life lived for others isn't a life lived at all, and in Seneca's words, "So you must not think a man has lived long because he has white hair and wrinkles. He has not lived long, just existed long." When we are young, we tend to settle for mediocre jobs, relationships, finances, and so on, because we fear failure and worry about what others will think about us. We do many things, live in the right neighborhood, buy the right vehicle, buy the right clothes, eat the right food, and so on, to gain the approval of others. And when we're old, we realize how foolish this way of thinking is, but then it's too late to go back in time. This feeling of needing acceptance is, stoically speaking, despicable and a worthless activity. It's no wonder that the biggest regret of the dying is living the life others expect of us, instead of living a life true to ourselves. Do you think you know how you spend your days? Write down your daily activities in a journal, and you'll soon realize things in there that you hadn't seen before. Patterns of behavior, habits, even useless activities. There is time enough in the day to meet all your someday dreams, but you have to make it and you have to claim it. This is why journaling is such a great strategy, because it will give you information, information you can use to change what needs to be changed. As humans, we estimate time passing in two ways. Prospectively, how fast is time passing right this moment? And retrospectively, how fast did last week or the last year go by? One reason that time seems to feel like it's speeding by is that we keep doing the same things over and over. Although there's comfort in routine, and some routine, of course, is unavoidable, it does make time fly. And if you want to get rid of that unsettling feeling on a Sunday evening that the weekend has flown by, there is something you can do. Make an effort to constantly seek out new experiences, because unique and memorable events slow down time, or rather your perception of time. For example, take up new activities at weekends and visit new places, rather than heading for the same bar or cinema. Even varying your route to work can make a difference. The more memories you can create for yourself in everyday life, the longer your life will feel when you look back. In the end, the present moment is the most valuable thing you own. It is the only thing you have. Don't waste it. Seize it. Live it. If you found value and enjoyed watching, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe for more videos.